Hey there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back with more LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. Last time, we completed Attack of the Clones and knocked out the first half of Revenge of the Sith in challenge mode. And now we will be continuing with the latter half of Revenge of the Sith here with Defense of Kashyyyk. Now this level, something tells me this level is going to be a little more difficult because while it is a pretty linear level, like Chancellor in Peril, it's a longer level, and there's a higher chance to miss things. So we'll go ahead and grab the first one there. Can go ahead and continue on. Oh wow, the ambient noise in this level is really cool. I like it a lot. And then up here we're gonna have looks like he's just the odd one out with his gun pulled there. Let's go ahead and put these together. Yeah, there we go. And we can just hop up. Oh, you can just walk right up there. That's pretty cool. You don't even have to jump. Well, anyhow, no sense in killing off these clones if they're not doing any harm for us. So let's go ahead and move on. Aha! I hear another jingle there. It's funny how depending on where the camera is, depending on, you know, like, how much the minikits jingle depend on where the camera is, not necessarily where your character is, which I think is kind of an interesting little thing. But I get the feeling that we are going to have to do some astro droid platforming across these panels here. So let's go ahead and do that, and then go ahead and grapple over to this way. Oh, does he not, is there one up there? Oh no, I guess there's not. Alright, well, we'll go ahead and switch back to the ghosts here. Okay, there is one up there. Where is my Wookiee defender? Well, here he is. Or she, I don't know. Okay, let's get rid of these clones. There we go. I was trying to focus on what I wanted to do there. Alright, yeah, we gotta free the Wookiees here, so let's get up here. Yes, put those guns away, boys. You won't be needing them. Your weapons, you will not need them. It is I, merely a friendly, well, maybe friendly but slightly, mostly friendly but a little bit hostile Force ghost. I don't hear. What is he? Oh, he was shooting at the Wookiee. I don't hear any more, so maybe we're in the clear as far as minikits go. You know, I've been trying, since I've started narrating audiobooks and trying to get into voiceover, like voice acting and stuff, I am a lot more conscious about kind of like the sounds that my mouth makes, like just like weird clicks and noises and things, and I feel like saying this might be kind of like shooting myself in the foot here, because maybe it'll make some of you guys notice more than what I would like, because you know it's like you won't be able to unhear it now, but maybe not. I don't know. Maybe this I use a different microphone for recording videos than I do for recording audiobooks. So yeah, so it's very it's made me just kind of hyper aware of how I'm talking and enunciating words, and I'm sure a lot of you guys are going, oh god, finally, now he'll stop making that sound. And I know I've seen a lot of comments of people saying, like, you make that noise way too much, and it's just, sorry man, I can't help it, I just don't think about it. Is there any minikit in this area? There's one up there, okay. Nice. It's crazy how this level goes. I can't remember if I brought this up the last time we were here, but it's crazy how this level goes from, as you progress through it more, it's crazy how it goes from like sunset, or no, from daytime to sunset to nighttime. So we'll be leaving the sunset area now, and yeah, going into the nighttime area through the rest of the level at that. don't know. It's just like those little things that you don't immediately notice, but still just make it so much more immersive. I will say that is, and kind of going back to what I was talking about last episode about sound effects, and earlier on in this episode also. There's something to be said for that. It makes me appreciate this game all the more that there are all these great sounds in it. Can I? Oh, I can just walk right through the rocks. Okay, or the boulders, I suppose. The last one's got to be in the final area, I'm sure. Nice. Ah, but we got to get Anakin up here. Crap. All right. Well, let's go ahead and get him up here. I forgot, you can't, you know, the AI in this game doesn't know how to triple jump because it's not as smart as the human players. And don't ever forget that. AI will never be as smart as humans. Yeah, I don't know. I know there's been a lot of stuff coming up with AI recently, and you know, it's been able to, you know, they're making a lot of strides with it. And, you know, they've been making a lot of strides with it in the last year, but I don't know. I wouldn't consider myself... Maybe it's just the old soul in me talking, and I wouldn't necessarily say I'm, like, behind the curve on technological or economic trends or whatever, but I don't know. I think it's one of those things where we ought to just take our time with that kind of stuff. I think AI might be moving a bit too fast for its own good, then, you know. And I'm not trying to sound like all doom and gloom here, but there's some things about it I don't trust. But anyway, that's kind of a topic for another video. Another video entirely that's not even related to this channel. Back to it here with Ruin of the Jedi, and this one should be... Why is this... There, okay, there we go. That was weird. The frame rate was all... Frame rate was all glitchy there. Just kind of lagging behind a little bit. This level should be... You know, Defense of Kashyyyk was actually quite a bit easier than I thought it would be, so I'm thinking maybe this level will probably be pretty easy, too. Let's see. I know, I can see... Oh, wow. It looks weird off in the distance there, off to the right, kind of like that void of nothingness. And then I still hear... Yeah, let's get on up this way. Yeah, it sounds like it's up here. Would it be behind? Oh no, it's just hanging out right there in the open. Now, do you just have to set one door down, or do you have to set... Oh no, you can just do one. Okay, perfect. Just have to do one door to get inside the Jedi Temple. And then I hear one. Yeah, I hear one kind of off to the right. Let's see. Move these stairs. Sounds like there might be one back this way, maybe? We can grab it. Oh, wait, it might be under the... Oh, no, it's behind the thing. Okay. Yep. Perfect. Wait, what the heck? Are they shooting at the... Oh, wait a second. Oh, no, they're not shooting at the... at the training remotes there. I was like, wait a minute. Are the training remotes, like, actually good guys, like, helping out the Jedi? But, no, that's not the case. Silly me. Alright, where is that? Oh, wow, look at that. They hid it behind the wall. That's pretty neat. Pretty clever, pretty mischievous of them, I will say. Good old traveler's tales. Okay. Sounds like there's one down here. Somewhere in the... Is it in the council chamber? Aha! There it is! Sweet! Oh, I just remember... Ah, oh, I just remembered. This one... I think, like Free Play, there's a lot of... I think all the rest of them are in this final area where we're gonna have to do, like, all those jump puzzles and movement of platforms and things like that. So... But that's okay, though. Open on up. There we go. And then, yeah, I can already see one up on the balcony up there. Is there one over this way? To the left, maybe? No, not there. Sounds like it's over there. Grapple on up to it. Okay, the final room is open. And now we need to get up to... There's Grievous. Grievous has been our high jump. He was our high jump character in free play also. Yeah, we need to get to the... Yeah, I need to get to the other side. Which I don't know if... let's use, just to be safe. Yeah, let's just fall down in here like that. And then go ahead and let old Anakin in here. Yeah, do that. Because I think we might also, depending on... See, that's the thing. I don't know if we'll have to raise up the other platform or not to get to... Actually, it just sounds like it's over here somewhere. Hang on. And then... Yeah, this should be... Yeah, and then number 10 should be in the final room. I'm just... Yeah, because I don't hear any more. So let's go ahead and make our way into the next room here. Should be just straight out in the open somewhere. Yes, there it is. All right. And that's that. And finally, we have Darth Vader. So I don't think I will need to cut out anything. Oh boy, I don't think I'll need to... Oh no, I'm already dead. Oh, I fell in. Yeah, I don't think I'll need to cut out anything from this level. It is going to go by so quickly that... Well... That it'll be over in a flash. Oh man, well, maybe not if I keep dying, though. I wonder where the second one is. It's got to be... No, is it just, maybe it's just the one mini kid in this opening area. I can't actually remember. I know I heard one up ahead. Yeah, maybe it is just that one in the opening area like that. All right, let's see. Yeah. That's that. There's a couple more over here, so that's good. No. Obi-Wan, to do that. There we go. Want you to keep this room from collapsing on our heads here. All right, so there's that one. And then number three in here. Use old R2-Q5, get in the secret room. All right, there we go. Number four. Gosh, I feel like I should have more by now. I mean, this level's not that long. I would think that... Although, you know what? I bet they're all out in the lava platform area. Outside here at the... towards the end of the level. That makes me wonder also if Force Ghosts can duel. That'd be an interesting... Like, if you put the two Force Ghosts up on the dueling platform like that, like you're supposed to at the end of the level... And now the characters kind of duke it out there. Would that be... I'm wondering if that would be kind of like... You know, I wonder if they would swap characters automatically. It's kind of... Yeah, I want to test that out. I want to see what happens with that. Okay. Alright, now I just gotta friggin' figure out where to go here. I don't have Jango or Boba with me, so... Oh, we're gonna have to do all this... All this platforming on our own here. Oh, okay. Oh, actually, oh no, we're not even gonna make it over to the platform because we need to. Yeah, we need to collect the last one, and it's right here. Yeah, if somebody knows about that and can verify that, yeah, does the AI forcibly force away from Force Ghosts? On the final platform there, that'd be an interesting little bit of trivia there. But I don't know what I'm saying. Anyhow, let's head on back to the cantina here. Because now we are moving into the original trilogy with A New Hope. So that ought to be... Yeah, that ought to be something. I'm betting... Yep, there we go. 6 out of 6. Yeah, I'm betting this should be interesting here. Let's go ahead and try out Secret Plan, see how we fare here. This will probably be the last level for this episode here, because it's a bigger level than really a lot of the prequel levels. And I imagine they've probably hidden these doggone blue mini kits all over the place on the Tantive 4 here, so. Why is the door not opening? Alright, there we go. Okay. Oh, wait, I hear one over this way. Oh, okay. There's one there. Let's see. And then I hear one over to the left. Right here. Oh, I can't go through unless I kill the troopers. Alright, well, let's go ahead and get rid of all them. This shouldn't be very long here. Oh, come here. Yeah, see, that's the thing. That's another thing that makes these original trilogy levels take a little bit longer is just the sequences. And that figures that there would be one down in there. Let's use Bossk to get to it there. Cool. And let's see. Yeah, we'll just go ahead and do that there. A little sequence break. All right. I wonder. Can Vader force push? Wow, he force pushes his own force ghost. All right, well, let's get rid of... let's be a rebel trooper and defend our ship here. Let's get rid of Vader like this. All right. Again, it's so weird to me that the rebel troopers don't dodge blaster shots, but I guess that's just how they were programmed. Alright. Switch back to our ghost buddies here. Switch back to our ghost buddies. Yeah, I'm primarily using Anakin and Obi-Wan.
Yabosca.
He doesn't make that noise. That's a Greedo noise. I'm primarily using Anakin and Obi-Wan here because... And not really so much Yoda, because Yoda is a bit slower. It's not like he, you know, is any different from his normal, regular, you know, non-Force ghost self. He is, there's one in the window over there. Yeah, Yoda, he still hobbles around. He's basically identical to his regular self there, still hobbling around on his cane. Okay, wait a second. Do that again. Right, and is there one? Don't hear one in the shower room. All right, so we can leave that behind. But I do want to check and see if there's one at the end of the hallway here on the other side. And wow, I am not hearing anything. So we can go ahead and leave this. We can leave this part here. Yeah, just head on through. Sounds like we grabbed them all. Gosh, listen how quiet it is on here. This must be what it's like for the rebels. Just an average. Confuse them all. This must just be an average day on the Tantive IV for the rebels. Not having to worry about troopers attacking the ship or anything like that. Just, you know, just complete and total silence. The mundane, you know, the mundane day-to-day, the monotony of their jobs. Sounds like it's in the next room. Yep, it's up there. So what if we just do that there? All right. And then, yeah, I kind of have no shame anymore about sequence breaking and things like that. I'm kind of just in for it to just get all the mini kits as quick as I can. We're on the home stretch anyway. We might as well. All right, so that's taken care of. Got our rebel buddies under under supervision by their stormtrooper chaperones here, but we'll go ahead and knock all these guys out. Yeah! There we go. At least they can, at least they're good at hand-to-hand combat, though. And then I hear one more, or the last one somewhere. Actually, let's just switch to this so we don't have to fight. Switch back to old Ben here. Sounds like it's in this way? Yeah, there it is. Nice. And we're done. Cool. Alrighty, y'all. Well, that will do it for another episode of Challenge Mode here in LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. So, next time, we will be continuing on with A New Hope. And I'm not sure how many levels we'll get done in the next episode, given that A New Hope's levels are quite large, but we'll see what we can do. So, until next time, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I will see you later.